In this video, I will show you an updated method on how to delete a Gmail or phone number from your Facebook account, especially if on an attempt to do that, you're redirected to check your WhatsApp messages. So be sure to follow the video to the very end, and if you find it helpful, don't forget to give a thumbs up and also subscribe to my YouTube channel, turn on the notification bell for more updates. Now, the solution to this apparently is that you have to first get your account locked. But before you do that, you have to first ensure that you have the necessary documents that will help you prove your identity so that you're able to unlock your Facebook account later on. And which means you have to first update your information to match with that on your documents. So now, to get your account locked, the first step is for you to open any browser, then go to facebook.com. So on the login page, you click login to another account. So from there, you select forgot password. Then after that, you will be prompted to enter your mobile number or search by email or name instead. So if you have the phone number, you can do that. Then once your account has shown up, then you click on it. So from there, when it asks for password, you click try another way. Now under choose a way to log in, you have to select the method that is available for you. And then you continue. So then you can go through the security check, then confirm. So an SMS code will be sent to that phone number. So once the code has been sent, then you can copy it and paste it. And then you continue. So from there, under create a new password, you're going to skip this step. So you click on skip. Then after that, it will log you into your Facebook account. Then now, Facebook is going to send you an email notifying you of the recent login. So you're going to go and open your Gmail app, then refresh. Then you have to open that email from Facebook that notifies you of the recent login. So from here, you scroll down to the very bottom, and then you long press on secure your account, and then you copy the URL. So after copying that URL, then you can go back to your browser, and then you first log out of your Facebook account, because initially it had logged you in. So you log out, after logging out, and then you paste the other URL on the search bar. So after pasting, then you enter. So from here, you will be asked whether you performed the action yourself or it was someone else. So you click on this was someone else. And now in the next part, if it brings this, you're going to click on the home icon button at the top right corner. And then you select new incognito tab. So you open a new incognito tab and then you paste that very link. Then enter. Then select this was someone else. So instantly after selecting this, your Facebook account will be locked. So now that your Facebook account has been locked, this is where we are going to start the whole process from. So you're going to open the new tab. So you click on the three dots at the top right corner, then select new tab. And then you go to facebook.com. So from there, it will show that your account has been locked. And then from here, you click on get started button at the bottom. Then it will take you to the steps on how to unlock your account. The first one is to confirm that that is your account, then secure your login details and your account will be unlocked. So you select next. Then now you have to confirm your identity. So you click on that. So from here, the first step is to either enter an email address or phone number that Facebook will use for reaching out to you. So then you click next. So then you enter an email address. So you have to ensure that you enter an email address that has never been used for creating any other Facebook account. So if you enter an email address and you find it has been used already, then you have to select the option of WhatsApp. So you click on WhatsApp, and then now from there you will enter the phone number that is registered on that WhatsApp account, then select next. So then you enter the confirmation code that has been sent to that WhatsApp number. So after that, you select next. So from here, you have to choose the type of ID to upload, and that's why I mentioned in the beginning that you have to ensure that you have the necessary documents. So for me, I will choose the national ID, and then you go ahead and upload a photo of your ID. So after uploading, then you submit. So after submitting, your document will be subjected to a checkup, and after that they will inform you that they will need to take a closer look and they will get back to you. So from here, you have to go and open your WhatsApp number that you had submitted. So you open that message from Facebook, and then now you can click on unlock your account. So when you click on that, it will redirect you to your browser. Then from here, now you have secured your login details, so you click next. So then now the most important part that we have been looking for is this one, where it will show you the existing contact information that is available on your account, the phone numbers and the emails. So you'll have to choose the ones you want to remove, so then you click next. Then from here, you can now go ahead and select the phone numbers or emails that you'd like to remove. So for my case, I'm removing the phone number, then you click remove, and then from here you click confirm, and those emails or phone numbers will be removed and you'll be shown the ones that are existing now. Then you click next, and then from there your account will be unlocked, and that is how you can easily remove the phone number or Gmail from your Facebook account. So I hope this helps you, but you can also try these other videos, and don't forget to share, subscribe and turn on the notification bell, and I'll see you in the next videos.